allemaal. Leuk dat je kijkt naar een nieuw report van Nieuws TV. Stefan, hoe vond je de wedstrijd gaan? Wat was jouw eerste songfestival die je meegemaakt?
Wat doe jullie voor opleiding?
De Thomas More, Papabo.
Vergeet geen blauw duimpje omhoog te doen of abonneer op mijn kanaal.
Hello, welkom bij een nieuw video van mijn YouTube channel Nieuws TV. I'm standing here with amazing Kiera from Malta. She presented Malta in 1998, 2005 and 2009. What was the best Eurovision experience about that three times that you represented Malta?
I think for me, the best one was the first one. Obviously, everything was new, so it was very exciting.
And what was the difference about the 2005 and 2009?
I don't know how to explain it, but obviously you know exactly what you're expecting and you know exactly what is expected from you. So there were a lot of high expectations from my country and also from my fans around Europe. And so that was, the responsibility was more felt in 2005, 2009, than 98.
Okay. And you meet, it was a year with Cecilia. How was it to, with Cecilia Romley, with Hemel Naarden, you know? The Dutch entry into 1998, you know that?
Yes, okay.
How was it to with her there in Birmingham?
She was very, very nice. She was one of the nice, one of the nice artists.
And what's your favorite about that year?
My favorite about that year, I think, had to be Ireland.
And why Ireland?
Because it was a ballad and I love ballads, so.
What is your favorite Eurovision ballad? Yeah, from Ireland or?
It's Hold Me Now from John Logan.
cool. Have your career have your?
From John Logan.
cool. Have your career have your career changed after Eurovision?
Yes, obviously it exploded. I was just starting singing in Malta, and it. My career exploded right after the first Eurovision, so.
Yeah, and how was that for you?
Well, obviously it was very nice, and I am still getting the fruits of Eurovision now, after all these years. I mean, it's been over 20 years, so it is quite a journey.
Cool. Are you excited for to perform your songs tonight?
Yes, I am. I can't wait.
Do you sing all three?
I will sing all three, and I will also sing another three from Eurovision, which I like, which is Hold Me Now, Euphoria, and Je ne sais quoi.
Cool. Have you advice for the artists participating at this year about Eurovision? Do you have a golden advice or maybe to...
My advice is always the same, like be yourself and believe in yourself, because the first person that believes in you has to be you. You cannot... tell people to believe in you, expect them to believe in you when you don't believe yourself. So you have to believe in yourself and always keep your feet on the ground.
Good luck and have fun tonight.
Thank you. Same to you.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Thank you.
More music. When the stars are shining bright and you're near, we're all more and more. I
from Eurovision Earth and from Nieuws TV. I'm speaking to Anna Bergendahl. She represented Sweden in 2010. She's also competing in Melody Festivalen in the past. So, how was your experience with Eurovision?
It was great. It's been a while. It's been 14 years since I competed in Eurovision. So I was very young. It was a lot of fun, a lot of nervousness. It was an amazing experience, of course, for me as a young artist.
So basically, would you like to compete at Sweden again?
To compete in Sweden or for Sweden?
For Sweden.
Absolutely, I would love that. Yeah, totally.
So from the three times you've been in Melody Festival, which one was your favorite?
Well, it varies. Sometimes, you know, I like This Is My Life better than the others, and sometimes it's Ashes to Ashes. Right now it's Kingdom Come. Yeah.
So anyways, I was wondering, like, Eurovision, how did it change your career?
Well, for me, it changed my career in a way that wasn't really good for me, because I didn't make it to the final. I get kicked out from the semifinal, which had never happened to Sweden before. So the results were not really good for my career. But I somehow I managed to. It took me a few weeks, maybe a couple of months, to get over it. But since I've continued as a songwriter, and I've continued touring in Sweden, and sometimes I get to do stuff like this. So somehow I think that the Eurovision fans still remembers me, and I think that they like me still.
So anyways, I was wondering one more thing. Can you say something to the fans of Eurovision Earth and from the listeners to Nieuws TV?
Well, hello, Eurovision Art. I'm Anna Bergendahl. I hope to see you someday. Thank you for all your support. And maybe I will see some of you here tonight. I don't know.
Who knows? It's nice to talking with you.
Likewise.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you.
I'm standing here with Victor Krohn. Yes. He represented Estonia in 2019 with his song Storm. How was your Eurovision experience for Estonia in 2019?
It was amazing. I can't even imagine. It's been 5 years now, so quite some time. But it was very fun. My whole career actually took off because of the whole, that era with Storm.
Weren't you originally from Sweden?
I'm originally from Sweden. Yes.
Why? How did you represent it? How was the story about you represented Estonia?
I met a few years before 2019. I met a songwriter and singer from Estonia called Stig Resta, and he invited me over to visit Tallinn, which is the capital, and we wrote songs and a few years, and then we wrote Storm, and he asked me, "Don't you want to send this song into Estilau?" And I said, "Yeah, sure, let's do it." And then it happened.
Cool, that's very nice to see. Cool. What makes Sweden so good at Eurovision?
Sweden?
Yeah.
Oh.
Country?
Yeah. Well, I guess there's a lot of good musicians and producers and songwriters. I think that's the ground, because it's the songs usually. But then also the production, there's a lot of talented people working behind the songs and the staging, and it's not just only the song. So the whole package is high standard.
Is it better than the United Kingdom?
I don't know. I haven't tried for the United Kingdom, but who knows? Maybe I've done it for Estonia. Maybe I do for the UK someday as well.
You never know. You can't tell me. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
To meet you. That our fiction is really true.
singer Felicia Perez, right?
Why? Right.
Yeah, she represented Spain in 2011 with a song. What is the title? Can you say that in your beautiful Spanish title of your song?
Whoa, 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 oh, whoa, 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 oh. Y ahora que me quiten lo bailao, que me quiten lo bailao.
How was your Eurovision experience in Germany?
Wow, 13 years ago, wow, it's a unique experience for artists, for professional, personal. It's beautiful experience. It's the Eurofans, it's the love. love Eurofans. Love Eurovision.
Great. What is your favorite Spanish entry at Eurovision?
The song of Spain.
What's your most favorite?
Ven, vuelve conmigo, ven, que necesito tu amor, ven, yo no te olvido, vuelve conmigo, mi amor. It's years ago.
Okay.
Years ago.
Your beautiful voice, I like it very much.
Thank you very much.
What are you excited for tonight?
Eh?
Are you nervous for tonight?
Ah, no, it's more enthusiasm, positive the night, the beautiful party. Is the music will speak for me. Porque my English isn't very good, and the songs will speak for me.